JZY.
Well, it's the final day of our great dog march in the Christmas parade in Charleston. Amid all the canine chaos here, there are some really heartwarming stories. Aggie here is on a tough road to recovery from a serious condition. Camman Ron Lee has the story.
Being around close to 100 dogs over the weekend in a hotel has taught me a few things. There's no such thing as leftovers at dinner. A guy's best wingman at a bar comes with four legs, and the alarm clock at 5 in the morning kind of sounds like a harp seal. This is the last event of a three-day celebration of the Basset Hound. Folks traveled for hours, in some cases days, just to get to Charleston to march in the Christmas parade. Apparently, some of the spectators traveled quite a ways, too.
We drove thousands of miles to see this.
To see the dogs?
Yeah!
Where are you from?
Charlotte.
I'm from Charlotte. I did not drive thousands of miles.
Something else this weekend has taught me. There's no greater love than between a dog and his owner. One will do just about anything for the other. This is Lisa Sullivan and her dog, Aggie. Aggie was adopted as a puppy, but as she grew older, she developed a condition that bowed her front legs out, making it harder and harder to walk. There was surgery, but it's expensive.
We're up to $10,000.
While a lot of people would have just given up, Lisa couldn't. She got online and started selling.
Here's everything I own to pay for her surgery.
When that wasn't enough, she started working at the vet's office to pay off the bills.
So I've been working two jobs for over a year now, but I'm going to do what I can to help my baby.
Aggie's still not able to walk with the other dogs, but even though the season has passed, she's still hoping there's a little Christmas miracle left over for her. In Charleston, I'm Camman Ron Lee, WBTV News 3.
Boy, if you'd like to find out more about helping Aggie, you can visit our web channel, WBTV.